You.
This might actually be a challenge. Good.
My turn.
My turn.
Right. Hang in there, everyone. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
This.
Turn.
Let's do this!
Very well.
It's my turn! Hang in there, everyone!
I don't need your help.
I'll handle this.
Arcus, activate!
Now!
Appreciate it!
Arcus, activate!
Yeah!
My turn.
Turn. My turn.
Ah.
my turn! How about this? My turn!
Ha! I'll handle this.
Arcus, activate!
It's my turn! How about this? Here we go! Go! All right, let's do this!
Leave it to me!
Leave it to me!
Thank you.
My turn. Arcus, activate. Ha! Right.
I don't need your help. I'll handle this.
Go! Arcus, activate! Huh.
Leave it to me!
Arcus, activate! Huh.
Very well.
Did it.
That was tough.
I thought we were done for.
I have no intention of letting filthy beasts get the better of me, trained or otherwise.
Honestly now, this is no laughing matter, you know.
Look who's talking. You're grinning like an idiot.
Not as much as you are.
There they go.
I don't think we could have wrapped this month's field study up more perfectly if we'd tried.
We were all able to form combat links with one another, too.
Damn.
We're not through the woods just yet, it would seem. If you want to arrest us, go right ahead. I chose to return to my studies. Well, what's it to be? Accusing my classmates of this crime will implicate me as well. Enough! We may not be the best of friends, but I am Eustace Alvarea. I will not simply stand by and watch as one of my classmates is arrested under false charges and used in a tool in some political war.
Eustace?
That will not be necessary.
Impossible.
I received a message from the Academy at noon today, and I returned by airship as quickly as I could. With your instructor.
What?
Looks like you've all done a fine job.
Instructor Sarah?
What are you doing here?
I've been filled in on the circumstances, more or less. I'll take care of matters here. You all return to your posts at once. I've already informed my father. Or do you intend to embarrass me beyond your other transgressions?
Oh my. Well, you can tell they're well trained, if nothing else.
The Provincial Army takes its training very seriously, of course. Though I resent the mere notion that it could be misused so grievously.
I'm sure you do.
So, what brings you here, Instructor? Seriously, why are you here?
Your timing is a little too convenient.
Did you come after receiving word from the Provincial Army?
Nope. I actually heard about what was happening a little earlier from a friend of mine. As soon as the news reached my ears, I shot to my feet and got right in contact with the director here. And he was kind enough to give me a ride on his airship back from the capital.
I don't know what to say.
Honestly, you seem to be prepared for virtually everything. Wait a second.
Director? Oh, you don't know yet, do you?
I also serve as a permanent member of the Academy's Board of Directors. Perhaps we'll have the opportunity to meet again in that capacity.
The Board of Directors?
Why is this the first I'm hearing of this?
I decided to keep it a secret so I could see the look on your face when you found out. I'm not the only member of the board, though, of course. I'm simply one of three permanent members.
That explains why you knew so much about Class 7.
Way too well prepared.
Still, I had no idea my father would attempt something so foolish while I was away. He's always been an obstinate man, but he's simply gone too far this time. As a member of the Academy's board, I cannot remotely condone the unlawful arrest of a student.
Rufus.
Thank you for your concern.
And you call yourselves teenagers. Unlike me, you actually get to go to sleep every night. You should be full of energy by this point in the day.
Give me a break.
Considering all that's happened this weekend, I think we can be forgiven for being a little tired.
Well, that's certainly true enough. Group B had their fair share of problems to deal with as well, but they weren't quite as serious as yours. Although they were of a similar nature.
What do you mean exactly?
Did they also wind up getting involved in a conflict between the two factions?
More or less. Saint Arc is another territory belonging to one of the four great houses, after all. So they got themselves caught up in a bit of trouble. The four of them managed to get through it together in the end, though.
Well, that's good.
That's a relief, yeah.
But, Sarah, Orak's fortress is nothing to worry about, is it? It's beyond a joke.
So I've heard. And the Provincial Army isn't the only force trying to improve its armaments. The Imperial Army is doing the same, with the Blood and Iron Chancellor and his 20 armored divisions squarely at the center.
Really?
How should the Military Academy... How should we act in a situation like this? Thor's graduates join both the Provincial and Imperial armies, right?
That's nothing you need to be worrying about. Not right now, at least. You're at the Academy to learn. That's all you should be focusing on. While you're there, it's true that you may be forced to acknowledge some of the more unpleasant realities of Erebonia. But I believe there's something special to be gained from that. Something you can only gain now, at this moment in time. So long as you're together with your friends and classmates, people for whom there is no substitute. Maybe when you graduate and go out into the world, much of what you've learned at Thor's will have little meaning. But I still truly believe that sometime, somehow, what you experience as part of Class 7 will be an invaluable treasure to you. It may not seem that way now, but I know in my heart that it will someday.
Instructor.
You almost had me there for a moment.
That was the last thing I ever thought I'd hear from you.
Hey! What's with all the laughing? I'm really sorry. Your words were quite touching, but...
Coming out of your mouth, they were just...
painfully droll.
Something we can only gain now, at this moment in time. So long as we're with our friends and classmates, for whom there is no substitute.
Stop that! Are you trying to kill me?
You kids are awful! I was being serious, you know! Why must this instructor thing be so difficult sometimes?
Bust in and save them. I thought it was all over when I got spotted at the fort, though. Hey, hey, White Rabbit here! Uh-huh, everything went A-okay. Don't sweat the details. I did what I was supposed to. No sign of them, though, but I did find a bunch of other interesting stuff. What? Fake intel? Someone managed to get a leg up on you and Gramps? Must have been one heck of a guy. Huh? Me? I'm gonna go meet up with Claire now. Gotcha! See you then, Lecter! is all about. Sounds kind of fun. Lammy! Yep, we're done here. Let's get going, Eric Getlem.
Keep up the good work. Good showing, everyone.
It was the middle of June. With summer well underway, a rainy spell seemed to hang over Trista. With our field study wrapped up, the other members of Class 7 and I returned to normal school life. But just when we thought we'd gotten used to the challenging lessons and the breakneck workload, a moment of dread washed over us, making our blood run cold.
As you all know, tomorrow marks the start of your midterm exams. I'm no good with all these papers and essays and circling answers, so I won't really be able to help you much. But I'm administering some of your tests, so I'll be cheering you on from the sidelines. Make me proud, class!
As I recall, aren't you in danger of a lecture by the vice principal if our performance isn't up to par?
Oh, I'm not too worried about that. Most of you tend to get pretty high grades anyway. I can hardly wait to see how well you all do. Remember, the results will be announced next Wednesday. Your scores will be posted on the board by rank, so you can see how you compare to the other classes in your year.
Oh, the sooner this week is over, the better.
I can almost taste the tedium.
I'm not gonna let Emma squeak by me again this time.
Oh, one more thing. They're gonna stick the average score for each class up there on the board, too.
Our class averages?
I suppose their intent is to furnish us with motivation in the form of class bragging rights.
Well, I do enjoy a challenge.
Anyway, I know it's only noonish, but I think that's enough homeroom for today. You guys can stay here and study, or just head on back to your dorms. Up to you. Prez, if you'll do the honors.
Yes, instructor.
Stay.
Excuse me. I do apologize for stopping you on a rainy day like this. Do you know if this is the building in which I might find the principal's office? Thank you for your kindness. But I couldn't possibly trouble you more than I have already. I'll be able to find the way, I'm sure. Well then, if you'll excuse me, Master Reen.
To cram a little more. But I figured I'm not gonna learn much more today, so I might as well call it a night and start prepping for tomorrow. Sure, okay. Thank you.
Welcome back, my lady. Huh? What? Sharon? It's so delightful to see you again. What are you doing here?
She did it. Mother didn't...
But of course, I was sent here at the behest of the chairman herself. Starting today, I will be assuming the position of caretaker for Class 7's dormitory. It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance, everyone. My name is Sharon Kruger. I am a servant in the employ of the Reinford household, Lady Elisa's family. Do all I can to be of service to you, so please keep me informed of anything you might need.
Simply spectacular.
Just how many different types of food are there here?
This looks more than edible.
I believe this is what they call an imperial breakfast.
That's right, Emma. It's a traditional Erebonian style of breakfast. I must apologize. It's taken me some time to familiarize myself with this kitchen, so my cooking has been a bit lackluster.
Come now, Sharon. Your skill is something to be praised. This is far more colorful and varied than the breakfast served in my own home.
I would compare this spread favorably with the breakfast served in the Duke's household.
I'm honored that you think so. I've also brewed both tea and coffee if anyone would like some. The chairman sent me to keep an eye on you like that. She simply sent me so that her beloved daughter might have fewer inconveniences in her daily life.
I can take perfectly good care of myself. Thank you very much. Oh, fine. I'll take this up with her myself then. Is she in the office of corporate today, or is she out on inspection or something?
I believe she'll be dining with the Ministry of Railways president in the capital today. After that, she'll be continuing her inspection tour, so she won't be back in Ruhr for another 5 days.
Does she ever slow down? I'm surprised she doesn't burn through a pair of shoes a week. Anyway, I'm not going to take this lying down. She's stuck her nose into things one too many times. Anyway, Anyway, I object to everything about this. Considering how busy Mother is, I'm sure she needs your assistance far more than I do.
I knew it. You're really concerned about her, aren't you? The way you two care so much for each other deep down is one of the reasons I'm so proud to serve you.
That's preposterous!
Oh, my lady, I almost forgot to mention that I made plenty of your favorite apricot jam. Would you like me to spread some on your toast?
Ooh, really? I mean, stop treating me like a child. So yes, I would like some jam.